There's a son who's our advocate, our defender, our friend. And we're here for that. Amen. How many of you came here for him tonight? I read in the Bible and I look in this like whole meta narrative, the whole story through scripture is a God who can't help himself but move in on his people, right? You have in the garden, they walk in the cool of the day together, right? And then we have this fracture, this break in the sin, and we see a God who has a plan from the beginning, doesn't he? He has to be with his kids, he has to be with his children. And you see him closing the whole story, isn't it? So we're coming for that, so we're coming for a show. All of that is fine and good, but we're coming for Jesus to move in closer. So I want you to put out your hands like you're receiving a good gift. And then we have in John 1, it says, Jesus came, the Word became flesh, and he what? Moved into the neighborhood, it says in the Message Bible. I have a sense today that Jesus wants to come move into the neighborhood. That's what I want you for yourself to just say, come Lord Jesus. Come, Lord Jesus. Use your words, use your mouth, and just say, come, Lord Jesus. Move in on us, Lord Jesus. And I even feel like when he comes with his presence, he comes with a whole bunch of things, right? He comes with healing, he comes with families restored, he comes with finances, he comes with everything that we need. So with your hands stretched out, asking him to do that, God, we say that you are good, you're a good father, so we come and we ask, we come with great expectation. We say that you are good, you are good, and we can't wait to encounter you in your presence.
We know who you are to know. it's who you are.
Breaking the alabaster jar at his feet, giving